So Amrita, thank you so much for agreeing to talk to us. Tell us what the scene was like yesterday late night at Dindorshi police station when you went.
So yesterday I went with a complaint letter which said that some people have put up my address on a Facebook page which has more than 10 lakhs followers and it creates a threat to my security. When I presented that with me, our group members, some citizens came whom I did not even know, till then. And a lot of also Adivasis from nearby areas came as a support. We all went and we met the assistant commissioner of police and he mentioned that he did not think that there is a crime that has been committed. Though I mentioned that putting up somebody's address itself is a crime like this on a social media page, and he said that he will check with the cyber cell and come back to me on what should be done, under what section they can file an FIR. Something was little funny is that he said that he will have to send a person to cyber cell to find out under what section FIR should be filed. But yeah, they were cordial and he heard me out. So I hope that they will quickly find out how a section under which section they can take action against those people.
Amrita, the Save Aarey movement seems to have captured the imagination of Mumbai after a long time. That Mumbai seems to think about the fact that 2700 trees are going to be felled, the Adivasis living there, 200 and plus Adivasi families, 10,000 people. How did you achieve that? I mean, how did this movement grow? What is the kind of solidarity?
So Save Aarey movement is a citizens initiative where there are different NGOs also which have taken part. Vanashakti is one of them. But what is really heartening to see is that how over a period of time always new people have joined, especially young generation, and they have made a huge difference to the movement. Why have they joined? Because they really, really believe in the cause and they believe that the city is becoming inhabitable. The way...
Uninhabitable.
Uninhabitable. Because pollution level is increasing. Now, every winter, we see Mumbai is under a haze. During summer, we have water crisis because we depend on rainwater. And these lakes are supplying us water, and during monsoon roads are getting flooded, and this is where I think the young generation has started realizing that they cannot live in this city for another 40-50 years if our environment starts degrading. And the way situation is getting deteriorated, this year 4 times our city got flooded. Earlier British during summer, they used to leave the places and used to go to the hill stations. Probably during monsoon, we Mumbaikars will have to leave the city, stay somewhere else and again come back. This is the way city is getting flooded and it is difficult to manage life.
The discourse between the government authorities and the citizens seems to become key. What is development? Because this whole model of development that is being thrust down our throats. Because this whole argument that there's no other land for the metro shed, they're trying to accuse protesters of being against the metro and against the development. Can you just tell us how you managed to message out the fact that Aarey is the green lung of Mumbai? That Aarey, this forest which we need to preserve, is like a green lung of Mumbai which has otherwise destroyed its forest, its trees.
So this movement started 5 years back, and at that point of time also citizens who used to go in Aarey for a walk, they were the people who stood up for the trees of Aarey. And what happened is that over a period of time we organized a lot of events. In fact, now these young people, they are doing more number of events. We do tree appreciation walk, we do small workshops where people come and take part with their children, with their family. And whenever somebody walks in, they can see it. A forest can be sensed, a forest can be seen. Nobody needs to actually prove that this is a forest. Yes, this, there is another fact that there are a lot of scientific data which is available to prove that Aarey is a forest. Many researchers had carried out research on the flora and fauna and the kind of species you find in Aarey, which can be found so many in large number only in a forest area. So that says also Aarey is a forest. So this data, people's own experience, our young generation creating content, sharing videos of Aarey, everything put together has created this awareness.
You were saying that yesterday when you had to go to the police station, you just gave Adivasis sisters and brothers 45 minutes notice and you were overwhelmed by the sense of community that they've displayed. So what do you feel about this whole synergy between the 10,000 persons who are Adivasis who are living there, 200 families and the rest of the citizens who are working together to save Aarey?
Yeah, this is something very nice that has happened, because earlier always people used to say that there is a disconnect between the grassroots people and the, you know, so-called English speaking or any other speaking people staying in building, you know, the people from that kind of social background, there was a disconnect. But today we see that in large number people are coming out in support of also the Adivasis, and many people they say is that we did not know Adivasis stay in Mumbai. In fact, the fact is that there were there are still 222 Adivasi hamlets in Mumbai, and this was recorded by Tribal Research and Training Institute. But in the DP, these Adivasi hamlets are not shown.
Aarey has 27 notorious development plan
that doesn't show this Adivasi hamlets, this 27 Adivasi hamlets which are there in Aarey. But yes, now we see that this communication is happening from all people from all walks of life, and that is what will bring in a change. So that's the kind of, you know, I think collective effort we need to see in the society to bring in a positive change. Otherwise, really, it will become very difficult to sustain our life if development goes, if development keeps destroying our natural areas.
Last message, if you can give us, to what you have learned from the Adivasis. You were talking about their sense of community.
Beautiful thing about Adivasi community is that they share all the moments together. So be it a moment of joy or sorrow or tension, they are always together. Somewhere probably that sense of togetherness was going missing from urban society. Many a times we used to say that people say that we don't have time. But today we see that the entire society is coming together. They are standing up in Aarey or in other areas. And I think that probably slowly again this will come back, that the sense of togetherness, that we all are together and we are here to live together, not to do things against each other or point finger, or when somebody is saying something and I don't agree with that, to name the person that, okay, you are so and so, hence you are doing this. Instead of that, probably that acceptance again will come, is that okay, we all are here. We are different people, but we may have different opinions, but everybody has a position in the society and we all exist here.
You have hope in the court case that you're fighting?
Yes, this is why we are in the court, and we have put across a lot of data. In fact, yesterday only in the court, it became evident that consumer land, which was one of the option, is actually there is a large plot of land which is free of litigation. And Stalin, Vanashakti, our other group members, Zoru Bathena's case, all are still going to come. Stalin's case has been heard, Zoru Bathena's case will come, and there are more cases which are coming. And definitely we believe in the court, that's why we are there.
Thank you so much, Amrita. Thank you so much. All the best for the struggle.
Thank you so much.